Hello.
All right, so I see Austin's little portrait thing. Has he actually showed up yet?
Oh, yeah.
No. Drink more cash.
Hello.
Hey, is it working?
It is working. I can see you fine.
Can you hear? Yeah, I guess you can hear me because you answered. Yep.
Yes.
No, we can't hear you at all.
Hey, just taking an educated guess.
Oh. You okay?
Hold on.
Steve, are you all right?
No, I'm not.
What happened?
I hit my elbow on my computer screen.
Oh, no.
Ow.
I'm trying to enjoy this delicious steak that we cooked over the break. I don't know, I'm in pain.
That's awkward.
All right, we're all set.
All right, cool. So, now that James has left, we've got someone new to replace him.
Yes. Hello.
Hello.
All right, Austin. I don't know how much of the stream you've been watching, so I don't know if you actually know who these characters are.
I didn't actually catch who specific characters were. Just sort
That's
of the
fine.
General plot.
Austin, you go first, then. Who are you?
Oh, okay. I'm playing as a an insane dragonborn warlock that was exiled from his clan for worshipping a great elder god.
Okay, what's your name?
Oh, as far as my name's Austin, and
is that your character's
Thank
name?
Thank you, Austin.
No, I don't know. I guess I'll just have him be Sartory, because that's what I normally do.
Alright,
that'll
work. He was
stripped of his clan name, so he just has the one.
Sartorius Rex.
Yep.
Yeah. I'm just doing some last touches on the next room. So, okay, let's go next on the line. Starchild, who are you?
She was up until the point that her daughter was up, so.
I don't know.
What's going on?
Someone was talking. I am
hold on a moment.
Yes.
Tom, is your mic muted? I think you might not be.
The blue logo on his face. Not white.
Yeah, Tom is not muted. That's Tom. Hold on.
Okay.
So mature.
Another guest pyramid.
She has so many animals.
All right.
Yeah, there's four animals here.
Chris,
two
where's
cats,
your cat?
A dog
I
and
need
a blind
it.
Hamster.
Hiding somewhere.
All right, so go ahead, Starchild. Describe yourself.
Yes. Well, I.
Oh, good.
I am a dwarf who thinks he's an elf who does ridiculous things with rope, and I'm going to.
About your height.
Do dragonborns have hair?
That's a good question.
Well, they normally do, but I don't. I lost all of mine.
I don't.
Oh
like
no.
I can't smell you.
We're the chat moderators. We need them over here. Get us out.
Who are these people who are talking right now? Is that are those
I
in your room,
Tom.
Steve?
Yes, they are. Unfortunately.
Oh, all right. Well, tell them that they're dead.
You have a very sensitive mic.
Is it super sensitive?
Yeah,
I guess. We can hear them super clearly.
Everything.
Oh, no.
Good for you.
Yeah. You need a drink more.
I'm sensitive about my height, and that's me.
Yeah, I put myself over here because Chris's stuff and all the comfy chairs are over there.
This is a comfy chair.
Well, most of the comfy chairs are over there.
The steak is right there.
You can feel free to bring the steak elsewhere.
You need the steak.
I had enough steak. I'm satisfied.
Oh, my God.
Wait, I have to interrupt this to tell a funny story. So
all right, go ahead.
The cat was laying on the chair next to me. And he started stretching, and being the not-so-bright cat he is, he stretched so far he fell off the chair. And when he hit the floor, he was like, what just happened?
Who attacked me?
Ah, funny cat.
That one is probably... Yeah, that's how it'll open. Okay, cool. All right, so.
I don't know yet.
Steve, who are you?
I am. Hello. I am Torin. I'm a hill dwarf who is 4.5 feet tall and proud of it. And my weapon is a giant wrench that's as tall as I am, and my armor looks like scrap metal that I riveted together myself because I did.
Weapon is a wrench.
Yeah, it's about yay tall. Yes. Like, like an adjustable.
Sorry, I just noticed Eli's comment in the Twitch chat, which is, where the hell is this campaign gone?
Where is the Twitch chat?
What?
Oh, you full screen chat.
Yeah. All right, so...
You people are watching us right now.
Eventually.
I'm on the internet.
12. All right. So, eventually, Metaton brings you over to the last room. Oh, wait, no, sorry. We need to explain the last two characters. Magnolio, who are you?
Hi, I'm Magnolio. This is a Magnolio. I have a giant magnolia flower for a head, and I play a guitar, and it's a bard on a quest for fame and glitter.
All right, nice.
I think I might dip into that next.
Okay, I'm Ursula. I'm mostly human looking, except for the fact that I have four arms that come out my sides and I can retract them. I'm kind of like a rogue, but I juggle, and I'm an alcoholic, and I'm obsessed with finding a unicorn.
All right, does that give you a pretty good summary of who these people are, Austin?
Sure.
All right, cool.
Can you guys still hear me?
Yeah, yes. You're fine.
I turn the mic sensitivity down.
That will probably help drastically.
I wonder why I needed to do that. Yeah, I have no idea why I needed to.
So you all talk louder. Great.
Oh my god. Fuck those people. Cats turned the lights off on Dan. Nice. All right. It didn't work. They're still coming through loud and clear.
No, so.
Did it not work?
It did not work.
How is this possible? Why do you have such a good mic? Even mine.
Razor makes.
No, yeah, that's super Razor Battlefield Floor branded quality.
Wow, maybe just like tell them that they're trash. Just put that out there.
You guys are trash.
All right. Metaton leads you to the door to the Necrodancer and is like, well, good luck anyway. Great. It was nice knowing you while it lasted.
Okay.
All right. Who would like to open the door, if anybody?
I'll do it.
All right.
I hope I don't get just wrecked by whatever's immediately behind it.
Get wrecked.
Wrecked.
Goodbye, Steve.
Goodbye.
Bye.
There's a colored floor and four zombies.
So those the colored floor are flashing different lights.
Excellent.
But like it's a disco floor. But
okay. I start discoing with three hands on the one side.
Nice. So there are speakers in the walls. So yeah, you are. Hold on.
Super bass jams.
With the fucking
raid.
Yo, get that bass pumping.
I forgot that we need to, we haven't done this in a while.
Wait,
what?
Why do
controllers
keep appearing at the back?
God damn it, fucking insert.
Watch the language.
Yeah, sorry. Screw insert.
You know, all those kids that are up at 12:35 a.m. watching this.
Have questionable habits. Come on, work with me here. Really not working. Alright, whatever. I guess we'll just have weirdly kerned titles. Alright. So... episode title. I'll switch it off for a moment. To do
covenant.
Yes. It's a new episode.
Nice.
Woo! Boy.
All right.
So.
Happy
news. There you go.
Happy.
You walk in, and the Necrodancer, who I think some of you might not have seen his portrait, so I'll toss this up here. Necrodancer.
Almost asked for her number.
Yeah. Essentially, says, "Welcome to your doom, adventurers."
Thanks.
Okay. Pretty blind of you.
Step to the beach and see if you can keep your feet.
Fun.
All right, everybody, roll initiative. Because the zombies are coming for you.
Awesome, that's exactly what I wanted.
Nice! Well, it looks like Torin rolled oops.
Uh-oh. Oops. Oh no, I crit failed.
And tomorrow he goes up to all the
It literally sounds like he is wearing the headset.
That's ridiculous because I'm wearing the headset.
Exactly.
You're imagining it.
Alright, is anyone else gonna roll? There we go, Star Child.
I was figuring out why it wouldn't let me roll initiative. I had to select my token.
That would do it. Alright,
I forgot. Oh, not what I have to do.
Rookie mistake.
Austin and Magnolio, could we get your initiative, please?
Yes.
Alright. Do you guys mind having a seat over there then?
Are we doing
that?
Unbelievably.
But being.
Do I just roll a d20 or is there something on your click?
It's just a d20 plus your dexterity.
I don't know what the number is at right now. But... I don't know, man.
Oh, plus one. Dex. Okay.
Anything you do obnoxious.
I mean, you can donate a few bucks, and well, I already am crit failing, but you can make me crit fail again.
Nice.
Many times.
As many times. You are the rest everyone else. Everyone die.
Tell him that for 10 bucks he can bring your worst fears to life. That's actually a thing.
Yeah, for 10 bucks you can bring any character's worst fears to life. So they're horrified the entire time. But I would so appreciate it if you guys could have
these are the best rolls ever.
Alright, so. So Tori with the. Coming in strong with the 3.
Yep.
I'm sure there are others.
And Magnolio with the 8. Alright, cool. And then the Necrodancer is gonna roll his. Alright, he's also gonna crit fail, so.
Yeah, so many crit fails.
Had a double oops there.
You gotta try to keep the fuck delicious. I don't know what to call it, but it's got
to keep stopping. Yeah, so we'll just have everybody go there. Okay. So Ursula, you rolled the best. You can go first.
Okay. Let's see, what's my movement? Dan, what's my movement?
6.
It's 6? Okay.
Whatever the standard is.
Okay. Well, I can remember this. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. I think I can hit them from here, right?
Yep, it's a ranged attack.
Okay. So I'm gonna go there. I'm gonna only use 2 hands this time and juggle 3 swords just for the effect.
All right.
And then I'm going to throw the 3 swords.
Never
mind. Alright, so the first one misses, the second 2 hit. So that's 21 damage to the zombie. And that zombie is just toast. It's like, poof, gone.
Get wrecked.
Alright, Magnolio, you're up. Oh.
Wait, as a bonus, I gotta do my scavenging.
Alright, you do your scavenging. But Magnolio, it's your turn.
Magnolio... strums his guitar menacingly.
All right. Do you want to try to? Do you want to try to use the fire of your fire guitar at one of the
that's
the zombies,
a way
maybe?
Yeah, yeah.
All right. So walk up to somewhere near a zombie, and you can shoot fire at it.
All right.
Is the mic any better now?
Wonderfully.
Alright, cool. So I figured out that Chrome was taking control, and apparently still is, and just adjusting it on its own. Great.
Gotcha. There's probably a setting you could do to override
that.
Yeah,
I'm trying to figure it out, but bear with me.
No problem.
So do I, like, roll to try and
set it on? Yeah, so roll some sort of attack. Probably, let's say, your dexterity modifier plus proficiency. So, like, I think that's, like, plus 6 or something like that. So roll a d20 and add 6. Let's say it's 6.
Oops, times 2. He crit the enemy crit failed twice.
No, he just crit failed slightly harder because he's already at disadvantage by being the bad guy.
Great. Is he the main villain?
No, but he's the main villain of this segment.
I was gonna say we can't like beat the campaign 10 hours before it's supposed to end.
Nah.
Right.
Are we about to beat D&D? Nobody has ever done that before.
Well.
Wait,
people
isn't
have
there
won
that one? Yeah, all right, yeah, isn't there that one guy who won?
Yeah.
Yeah, Old Man Henderson won, yes. Call of Cthulhu.
Similar, but not quite.
I don't know, at least I remember
significantly something. Harder. Magnolio, that'll do. So let's say 2d6 plus 4 is how much fire is shooting out of your face. I don't know. We're just ad-libbing this.
Yeah.
We're doing it live. could you roll that, or should I roll it?
Oh, 2d6, right. I completely forgot.
It's alright, it's very late, I get it.
All these dance teams.
So, 2...
I mean, this is the Necrodancer. Alright, that's 11. Cool.
It's a amount of fire. It's a pretty good amount of fire.
Nice. The zombie is bloodied and on fire.
Fantastic.
Can robots be bloodied?
Yes, but these aren't robots. They're zombies with robot bits.
Oh, okay. So they're cyborg zombies.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you for that clarification.
Starchild, you're up.
All right.
I don't know.
Let's see. I don't have that much, but I can move. 3, 4, 5.
There's so much in this campaign left. Oh my god. This is going to be a long night.
Can I do something very ridiculous at severe disadvantage?
What do you want to do?
Okay. So I'm going to make all my rope fiber ends together and try to twine the Necrodancer from here.
Twine him?
Entwine.
You can give it a shot.
I figure it should be something like 1d20 disadvantage minus 4.
That sounds fair. Disadvantage minus 4. There you go.
Wow. Good luck.
Oh, did not do that well. No, I should do this. It doesn't matter. I could do worse. That one worked.
5. Yeah, that's not happening.
I attempted.
Riches is starting up again. Yeah, it is. Alright, cool. Alright, so Tori, you're up.
Alright. So for spells that take an action to cast, do they like come into effect next round or this round?
Depends what the spell is, but usually it's immediately. An action is just what you're
Okay, cool.
It's equivalent to an attack.
Alright. Then I'm gonna cast Yvard's Black Tentacles.
To answer Inksplosh's question from the chat, yes on both counts. It is on purpose. It is also a problem with the mic. All right, so you are casting Bards of Black Tentacles. Do you have to make an attack, or do they have to make a save?
They have to make a save. It changes the terrain.
Oh, well, that's horrifying.
So get some tentacles ready.
All right.
So I'm summoning a 20-foot square of black tentacles. And,
20-foot? Oh, okay.
Within 90 feet of me. And when they start their turn there or enter it for the first time, they have to make a dex save. Otherwise, the tentacles grab them. And they're restrained by the tentacles and take 3d6 bludgeoning. And then they have to make strength or dex checks.
Where do you want it?
How do I make things? I wanted it like...
Click and hold and it'll make a ping. Click and hold and it'll make a ping.
Here. Is it not? To the right of the guy that's like...
Here?
Two squares below. No, the other one.
Here.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. You're in the measure mode as compared to the...
Okay. I got you. Yeah. Alright, so like the...
One sec. Let me drop this to the layer below it. Map layer. Yeah. There you go. I guess you can't center it. So that's the best I can do. Is that good for you?
Yeah. So that's classified as difficult terrain as far as moving.
Alright, does it do damage or just that?
Just the tentacles grabbing them, and the tentacles do 3d6.
All right, that is notable. If they what?
If they fail the save on their turn.
Okay. Torin, you're up first. Oh, you muted your mic.
Yeah, I'm just doing Twitter talk now. Right, alright, so I'm all the way back here. How far can I move in a turn and still attack?
You have a speed, however high that speed is, that is your distance.
Five. Five squares?
Five squares.
One, two, three, four, five. Alright, cool. So I have that, and I also have a lunge attack, which conveniently increases my range by five, should I hit.
Go for it.
Great, so I have to hit and then roll a d8.
Yeah, but you have to roll the hit first.
Right, exactly. Yeah, exactly. So.
It's a lot of tentacles.
It's a lot of tentacles.
Oh, there's more.
Austin's patron deity is essentially 4chan, so be careful.
What's happening there right now is a scene from Anaconda, like the horror movies.
Does that hit the thing?
Yeah, that'll do.
It's personally being seen from Anaconda, the music video.
Ooh, so. Anaconda, the musical.
Which is a combination of the two.
Right, so that hits, but now I roll the d8, and then essentially based on that, you decide whether or not, like, the lunge thing works, or if I just whiff miserably.
Oh, no, I think you already did the lunge, didn't you? You hit.
No, I guess the way this ability works is I now roll a d8 to see whether or not the lunge itself works.
Sure?
Unless you don't want to play it that way and just call it a hit.
Sure, whatever you want to do. I don't actually know what ability you're referring to.
Yeah, I'd rather just do it the easy way then. And it came out.
Okay.
Right. So great. So roll damage.
Okay, go for it.
Great.
What is this ability so I can look it up for later?
It's part of the fighter class and their maneuvers.
Okay, I'll look it up later. And
that
I'll.
Came from the player's handbook, whatever version that you sent out. So I don't know if it's that.
Good to know. I'll look into it. I'm just not familiar.
Yeah,
hey, Austin, you got a donation.
For how much? Jeez.
Don't know. But I just got a notification saying you got one.
Yeah,
go check it out.
Hooray.
Uh oh. These donations are dangerous business.
All right. That's actually enough to down that zombie.
Yes. Is it downed or dead?
It's dead.
Yes.
Austin, what's the save DC on your tentacles?
It's a 16 on... It's a dex save.
Holy moly, 16?
Well, it's based on my spell saves, right?
Yeah, that's high. All right, cool.
Yeah, that's a good
idea. Yeah, both of the little zombies fail, and then the Necrodancer... also fails.
Okay, so they...
How much
they get restrained, and then they take 3d6 bludgeoning each.
Alright.
So,
14 damage. Both of the little zombies are bloodied, and the Necrodancer is mildly inconvenienced.
Oh boy. We got a $5 donation from our friend Eli.
Which is gonna do what?
Let me take a look at my page. Probably be on my turn, so.
Yeah, alright, so we can wait for that. The Necrodancer is going to just send out a blast of purple light to attempt to sever the tentacles around him. Which he succeeds at. And then he will step out of this nasty business. Alright, Ursula, you're up.
Alright. So, I'm gonna go 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I can hit from here, right?
Yes? Hold on, let me actually check, take a look at that. Yeah, it's a little tricky, but you can do it.
Okay, I'm gonna move there. I can hit from there, definitely.
Much easier.
Alright, so.
You don't need to worry about accidentally slamming Magnolio in the back of the head with a sword.
Do it!
So this time I'm gonna bring out all of my arms and juggle all of my swords, but I'm only gonna throw 3.
Okay.
You can't throw all your weapons.
That juggling, just to, you know, that intimidation factor.
Alright, so the middle one's gonna miss, but the first and last will hit. So just to clarify, are you attacking the zombies trapped in the tentacle?
No, this
craziness?
Guy.
Okay, the Necrodancer. Alright, so he's going to take 17 damage.
Yeah. And then I'm
gonna scavenge. Okay. Nice. So Magnolio, you're up.
Alright, can I set the... Does the Necrodancer have a cape?
Yes.
Can I set that on fire?
You may attempt.
Alright, should I roll a coin?
Sure. Yeah,
As a bonus action, you should flip the coin and have that fire thing shoot out again at him.
Yeah!
Alright, flip the coin to see if it comes up heads or tails.
Alright,
Alright, it came out tails this time, which is the wings. Oh. And you immediately sprout angel wings and fly about 3 feet up in the air.
Oh, hell wow. Yeah! Who has great ideas?
Now I'm just picturing Magnolio like sweeping over a crowd, doing a power cord with fire shooting out of his thing, with like flying by.
Magnolio's life.
one of the strobe lights shatters and just glitter rains down.
He passed right there. Hands down, the best day of his life.
Alright. So could you make a quick attack roll against the Necrodancer to try to light him on fire?
Alright.
Domer Media. Domer Media.
So it's a... this, right?
Yep. Okay. It doesn't really hurt him, but it does light the cape on fire, so if he doesn't take it off, it'll start bothering him pretty quick.
Alrighty. Mission accomplished.
All right, Star Child, you're up.
Okay, so I do that, and I light Bruno on fire, right quick, and then I cast. Where's the button? That.
All right, could you? you did miss, but yes. Could you do your
Yes.
What's it called? Iambic pentameter verse?
Okay, all right. So. Fire. My desire.
is for you to rap Necrodancer. I think I was off by like two syllables, but that was close.
That was close. Just for clarification, he had someone donate to make him cast all his spells in iambic pentameter.
10 out of 10. Oh, so Eli's $5 donation was to name my god. So my elder god's name is now Bob Ross, the principal deity of incidents and joyous foliage. And I will use that whenever referring to him.
Nice.
His name.
All right, Sartory, it is actually your turn then.
All right. Well, I'm going to call upon the power of Bob Ross, the principal deity of incidents and joyous foliage, to make some, throw some insults at the boss here. Just with a little cantrip, you know.
Call him a happy little accident?
I'm a happy little accident. It's a happy little cantrip. Which is a vicious mockery. So we're gonna throw some insults his way. But, you know, it's all okay.
Steve, just bring up YouTube and Google happy little trees. Go ahead. You're rolling vicious mockery. Notably, you have to cast your spell in verse. So you have to say something that rhymes about your spell.
Oh boy. All right, Mr. Necrodancer. Your room is bright and full of light, but your heart is weak and can't stick to the beat.
Close enough. Sure, whatever, we can work with that. You tried.
I tried, at the very least.
Stay forever.
Yeah. Alright, go ahead and cast your spell now.
Okay. So it's a wisdom save.
Alright.
Again, 16.
Oh wait, sorry, yeah, he had to save? I'm sorry.
I
messed that up. I was waiting for you to do your roll, but there wasn't one coming.
Nope.
20.
Alright, he
makes it. Does anything happen on a miss?
No, he's just not insulted.
Okay. Torin, you're up.
Alright, I can actually move right in front of him. If I move through, like, if I move here and I'm here. Well, I guess I don't know.
You'd go through the edge of it, but I'm going to assume that you could just move diagonally and not
do
that.
Sure. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, my attacks are pretty uninteresting as fits my character. I am pretty tanky, though, so, like, standing here. Well,
don't you have some gadgets that you don't really know what they do?
I do.
You could always try and use a gadget.
Just use a random gadget for no reason?
Yeah, I mean, like, if you think.
I also have a robot arm.
Go gadget robot arm.
Yes. Maybe I'll take a particularly dangerous looking one of those gadgets and just kind of thrust it in his face.
All right. So does this look like a trinket, or is it more of a gun, or what is this vaguely shaped like?
Something dangerous. It might be a weapon that fires some sort of projectile.
Ah, projectile one. Okay.
I literally know nothing about it.
Oh no, absolutely. That's just, if you just describe it in some way, like what it looks like, we'll give it some silly name, and that will be what it does.
All right. Great. Okay. This it looks like you hold it, and then you sort of hold it with the tube facing away from you, and it has a sort of button device that it looks like you can operate in the hope
that
something deadly comes out of the tube in the direction of me and not towards me. That'd be great.
Alright, so then this is called your TikTok Displacerizer?
TikTok Displacerizer, I love it.
Alright, and you push the button and make an attack. Just roll as if you were making a normal attack with your weapon.
Great. Here goes, friends. No promises. Yes. perfect. Crit fail. Excellent. That's
looks like you were holding it the wrong way, which is really unfortunate.
Damn it.
And you're going to be teleported, let's say, here, and about, and about 15 feet in the air.
How? Make it fast.
Oh, okay. Well, if you're 15 feet in the air, you're above the tentacles for now. Oh,
so who
briefly,
has rope? If anyone has rope to, like, feel me in, like a fish, that would be great.
Roll an acrobatics check to try and, not crash.
That's a plus. Crit fail again, ready? Oh, no, not quite, but...
Oh, boy.
Yeah, alright, so you faceplant pretty hard and take, 6 damage. And then, make a save against the tentacles.
Yeah, dex save.
What type of dex save?
Yeah. This is absolutely your lucky day, Torin.
Okay, just a happy right, little accident.
That's my save.
Alright, you're actually...
Oh, boy. No,
oh, did you not make it? Oh, no.
Are you kidding me?
Just barely missed the friends. So you're gonna take 3d6 and you're restrained by tentacles.
Alright. Tentacles I can do. Nothing I've never dealt with before.
Alright, I'll roll it for you there, friend.
That's unfortunate.
There you go. Take 15
damage.
No.
15 damage, whatever.
Alright.
That's alright. It's okay.
So the Necrodancer is frustrated by his flaming cloak. takes a few points of damage as he's like trying to wrestle it off. And then, by the way, these two zombies that were in there are just absolutely dead right now. I forgot to say that. They just got ripped apart.
That's okay. That's okay. Tentacles are just trying to paint some pretty paintings.
Rips off his cloak, throws it to the ground, and is just like, damn it! All right, up the tempo. All right, let's see. And I'm gonna. Then he also conjures some more zombies.
But where does he conjure them?
Working on that now.
Is anyone here a melee class, or what's the deal with that?
I think it's just...
Just the guy already in the tentacle?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'm not anything. I just do what I want with rope. I really don't do damage. I just flail around looking ridiculous.
It's okay.
Okay.
Casually attacking my own team.
You'd fit in with Tom.
Waiting for him to come back. Then we can attack our own.
Alright. And then he's also gonna throw a quick beam at Magnolio, who he blames for the destruction of his cloak.
Wasn't a good looking cloak anyway.
Oh,
get wrecked. Does he take a point
of confidence? Wow, he missed. He was so distracted because of that major burn. Now his fingers and his dignity are burned. Ursula, go ahead.
Okay, so I'm gonna stay where I am. And I'm gonna throw my last 3 swords.
Alright, that's 1 hit.
Oh.
But that's 13 damage.
Mm-hmm. Alright, so I currently have 1 sword left.
Oh no!
I found when I...
You haven't been having much luck with your scavenging, have you?
No.
Bright side, she gets hella ways to dodge things if she's not juggling, so.
Oh, that's good.
When I stop juggling, I get advantage on stuff.
Cool. But Magnolio, you're up. What do you want to do?
I want to fly down and hit him over the head with my guitar.
Do it! just swoop by. That should be a higher number. I don't know what higher number it should be, but that should be a higher number.
Should I roll again?
No. I mean, your plus. It's three is what? What is your...
I have no idea.
Okay.
Hang on. Wait, what is... Which one I got the sheet right here?
I think you're attacking with your dexterity modifier, right?
Yeah, wait. What's the modifier for dexterity of 15?
A 15 is a plus 2, and your proficiency at this level is plus 3, so it would be plus 5 total.
Alright, there we go.
Alright. Oh, and there's a crit. Alright. So you're gonna hit him pretty hard. You're like, you really throw your momentum behind it as you just slam it in his face.
Does it push him at all?
Oh yeah, sure, you push him into the tentacles too.
Nice.
Feed him to Bob Ross.
That's
how
nice
we do it at our school.
Alright, so what's the damage on your guitar? Do you have damage for it yet or not?
No, I've...
Alright, that's cool. I'll make something up. Since this is a crit, let's roll 3d6 plus your dexterity or strength modifier, whichever one's higher.
That'd be my dexterity.
Alright, so 3d6 plus 2.
Plus... And roll.
And whoever's in green, I can't quite read it from here.
But it is very much possible that they are not statted correctly, but who knows? Alright, so yeah, he's gonna take 13 damage and then get pushed into the tentacles, and he'll have to save against that on his turn. Starchild, your turn.
Alright, so, gonna take the, not ridiculous route this time and try and actually be useful for 5 seconds, then I'll stop.
Be useful, find out you don't like it, stop.
Hey,
that's a hit.
Yeah, well, I hope so. Alright.
Ellie, I don't think anyone wants to see your butt.
Gonna go ahead and do that. Gonna say lightning this time. So here we go.
Alright.
Here we go. Lightning. Bite me. Bite me. Necrodancer.
Close enough. We can make that work.
I think I had 11 syllables, but that's
no, that was 10. You got it right. It was just some weird words in there. Questionable use of the whole syllables thing. Alright, so yeah, he's gonna take some damage now, right?
Yeah, so it's gonna be what level are we? 8.
7, 8? Hold on, what is
eight,
it?
8, so that would make me 10.
Yes.
Okay, so that's gonna be 66. And he's going, he's going to have to make a dexterity save or get disadvantage on all of the attack rolls.
All right.
After taking 19 damage.
But has advantage on this throw, right?
Oh, I have advantage on this throw.
No, that's not what it says.
Yeah, target
must succeed on a dexterity saving throw, but has advantage on this throw.
Yes, that is what it says. Okay. Sorry. Okay. Something else.
I mean, you wrote it. 19. Alright, so he shakes it off. Sartori, you're up.
Alright. Let's just hit him up with a nice little Eldritch Blast.
Just a reminder, there are zombies all around the room. They will start moving in next turn.
Is he bloodied yet?
Oh, is there one next to me? Is that what that is? Oh.
No, he's not.
Okay, then. Rude.
This is still fine. We're still gonna shoot him with an Eldritch Blast.
Okay.
Break his mask or something. Who knows?
How many beams is it at this level?
2.
Yeah.
So... Actually, I think I have it in my... Well, I know the... Oh boy, that didn't work. Alright, so it's a spell attack. Oh boy. We tried. That's okay.
Oh, it's a crit fail. Alright, let's see who's in your line of sight.
Everyone.
It's two different bolts. Right.
So, one of them is gonna blow up in your face, so just roll damage against yourself. And the other one's gonna hit Ursula in the back of the head.
Ooh.
Oh.
Wait,
is she juggling anything?
Alright,
well,
so
I only have one
sword
left, so I don't think so.
Oh, so you're not. Okay.
I think she has a...
Does that mean I have an advantage?
Alright, so make a dex save, and if you could beat, let's say, 13, then you'll get out of its way. Nice! That'll do it. You pull a sweet dodge and just kind of zips by you.
I extend all of my arms and do that cartwheel thing again.
Nice. What were you saying?
What am I supposed to roll as far as taking damage and losing concentration because of that?
Don't worry about it.
Okay. Tentacles are fine, then. Tentacles will stay.
Yeah. Alright, Torin. Are you gonna drag the Necrodancer into a cage match with the tentacles?
Alright, okay, so... So what can I do?
When you start your turn there, you're gonna have to make another dex save, because you're still trapped by them.
See if you're restrained or not.
Okay, so if
actually,
I...
you could choose to do dex or strength, because you're already entrapped.
Oh yeah, you can just try to rip your way out.
Okay, cool, so strength is definitely better.
Yes!
Yes! There you
good!
Go.
Alright, okay, so you have a choice. You can either just completely free yourself, or you could just, like, lunge and just drag the Necrodancer back in.
Is there a possibility I could use the crit to, like, body check him out and me with him?
Yes, absolutely. Right. Or you could just leave. Like, it's that is also a choice.
Yeah, but that's boring.
Alright, sure.
Boring.
So I assume we'll end up sort of, like, with me here and him to the left of me? Or however you think it would work out.
Yeah, hold on. Sorry, just answering this. Yeah, sure. He'll, make an attack on him, and you just get, like, a free advantage on this attack.
Alright, cool. So, do I just roll, like, a normal attack for mine?
Yeah.
Cool. And this attack...
I'm also going to have him make his save against the tentacles now to see if he actually was taking damage then or not.
Yeah, sure.
He was not. Okay.
So I'm going to use another one of those maneuver things.
Dice are right.
So it's a... If it works, he's frightened until the end of my next turn.
Nice.
If I hit, he does a wisdom saving throw.
Okay.
In order to determine whether or not he's frightened.
Okay.
And if he's frightened... Or that save will be 8 plus my strength mod. So he has to roll better than a 10 in order to not be frightened.
Okay.
According to what I have written down here. All right, going in. 13, great, 18. Does that hit his AC?
Yeah, that'll do.
Yeah, is he scared?
You need to... oh, wait, he needs to make his save.
Yeah, he has to roll his saving throw has
roll.
To be a 10.
Do 20 plus 3. 21. Yeah, he makes
damn
it.
Damn it. So he's still not scared, but I still do damage.
He is not spooked, but you still hit him in the face, which is unpleasant.
Great. Whoa, hold on. I did something wrong. That's plus 2, so it's... Wait.
That's 9.
Oh, so it's a 9. Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
So he takes 9.
I bonk him for 9 damage. Great.
So you hit him, and he is now even further frustrated.
And he's decidedly unafraid.
Yeah. And is like, tarnation, you meddling children.
Well, that's annoying.
Let's ramp it up even further. And summons 2 more zombies of rather large size.
Oh, they're big.
Big zombies.
Alright. Then the other zombies are gonna start making their move. Alright, this zombie is going to come after Sartori. He's going to make an attack on you. What do you get?
Is he hitting me?
That's going to miss. This one is going to
come after Ursula. This one's gonna come after Ursula.
Aww.
This one's gonna come after Starchild. This one's gonna come after Magnolio.
Hello.
And then the Necrodancer himself is gonna try to do Grasp of Death on Torin.
What is Grasp of Death? I wasn't prepared for
it, this. You'll see in a minute.
Okay,
so let's go against Ursula first. So two attacks on you. Boom, boom. Does a 23 hit your AC?
Nah, my AC is like 30. What are you talking about?
Does a 15 hit it?
Yes.
Okay.
Really?
So that's two
my
hits.
My AC is 15.
So, okay.
Because we're not in the room that increases it anymore.
All right, you're gonna take 18.
Uh-huh.
Star Child.
Yes.
That's a miss. Magnolio. Oh. You're gonna get attacked by a zombie with a cleaver.
Oh no.
But they take disadvantage because you're flying. So, does a 12 hit your armor class?
Probably.
Probably not. That seems very low.
Okay.
Do you have an armor class?
I mean, not really wearing much in the way of armor.
I know, but it would be listed at the top of your sheet, AC.
It's infinite armor class. He just doesn't take damage.
Yeah.
Magnolio has no time for these peasant games.
Right. Yeah, that's like below it.
Truly, the proud plant race has no.
I mean, he's a plant, so like if he gets chopped off, no matter how low, he just grows back.
That's fair. All right, yeah, whatever. Well, I mean, he's not going to take damage with this anyway, because I'm pretty sure that was going
to. I told you.
All right. Tony Patrick's for breakfast.
Indeed.
All right. Don't give any. The Necrodancer reaches out and pretty much grabs your face, Steve. And Steve, I need you to make a Constitution saving throw.
Plus six. I need to watch my crit fail. Ready? This is my best stat, everyone.
Nice! Nice. You're only going to take half damage on this.
Alright, that's fair. How much is half?
14 is half.
14 is half.
That's fine.
I thought you were tanky.
I am. I have hit points to spare.
But, like, it's still spooky.
Yeah. It's scary, but...
What is your HP?
88 total.
So I'm tanky.
What are you?
I have 100.
Yeah, that's a lot.
It's like twice what I have. Dim Heldor stats.
I know in your video you said 18 was AC. Do you do levels added onto that, or is it just if you're in heavy armor, 18 is your AC, and that's it?
It's just 18 is your AC.
Okay, yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Just making sure. That's what
Ursula,
I have.
Ursula, you're up.
Okay. So I'm gonna attack. Am I able to throw, like, two swords at one, and then one sword at this guy?
Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, so two are going in the pink square, and one's going in the orangish reddish thing.
It's just red.
Oh, actually, wait. I think I only have one sword right now. How many do I have? Yeah, I only have one right now.
You have two swords, because you had one. Oh, no, yeah, you're right. You only have one sword. But you could scavenge before you fight.
Yeah, I'm going to scavenge real quick.
Nice!
I got five swords.
You're back up to full.
Okay, so I can only throw three, so these first two are going to be at the guy in the pink.
Okay.
Oh.
They both missed, and the second one was a crit fail. So you go to wind up, and instead of throwing it, just kind of stabs Starchild in his back.
Hey.
I'm sorry.
So Starchild, make a dex save to not get horribly stabbed.
My dex is terrible.
Did you get your sword back?
Hey.
All right, you're fine.
Woo! Okay, and then this third one goes to the other guy.
That's also gonna miss.
Oh. But crit damage.
that was kind of an unfortunate turn.
Yeah.
Magnolia, you're up.
Alright,
Here, you could either try and clear out the zombies or just try and murder the Necrodancer and hope that they disperse.
I'm gonna go with murder the Necrodancer because I don't like his outfit. I don't know what it looks like, but I don't like it.
Magnolio is the fashion police.
Essentially.
Is that like your
fashion judge, jury, and executioner?
And like
all right, I'm gonna try and set the...
This is what his outfit looks like, by the way.
Oh, terrible. God, that's like so 2015.
Is that on fire?
He's capeless right now.
All right, so roll to set him on fire, I guess. Oops. Is that it? Or do I just... That's probably not it.
Huh. Someone really likes your juggling scavenging swords mechanic.
Ah! With all my arms.
All right, sorry. What were you trying to do, Magnolio? I missed that.
Set the Necrodancer on fire.
All right, go for it. So that's a hit because of your bonus that you didn't bother adding, but it's no big deal. So yeah, are you going to like for more of a burst just to hurt him now, or are you trying to like ignite what? So he'll burn for a long time?
I'm going for ignite.
All right, that's a good call. All right, so he is now on fire and will burn at the start of his turn, pretty much until the end of the encounter or until something puts him out.
Good, he deserves it.
All right, Ursula, if you could retrieve Starchild, that would be a good call because it's his turn.
I'm sorry, what'd you say?
Go get Dan, it's his turn.
Dan, it's your turn, yeah.
Oh! Just stepped on the cat.
Is the Necrodancer bloodied at all, or just on fire?
He is... Yes, he is bloodied.
Nice.
And after that turn, here we go.
He's got red on him.
I don't have a spell for this, but can I use my ropes to tie these three zombies together?
They showed up on the Necrodancer's last turn, yeah, Jess. Okay. Yeah, you could try.
Okay.
You'd need two ropes.
D20?
You'd need two ropes, because you need to send it out and then pull it in.
Alright, I'll use my standard ropes.
Okay, but yeah, sure. You could do that. So make two D20 rolls.
That's pretty good.
Alright, that's
do I
enough.
Have any intelligence modifiers? That.
Probably, but that's enough. We're good.
Okay. Cool. I think I incapacitated them.
Yeah. It's a concentration spell, so they're just kind of like slopped up in, against each other until you stop paying attention.
Alright. I'm just gonna chill right here, and can I light those ropes on fire for my bonus action?
Yes.
Gonna do it.
10 out of 10.
All right. So Tori, you are up.
All right. Let's just use shocking grasp on the zombie next to me.
Good to know.
Oh, are they wearing? I don't know if that hits. If it says if they're wearing armor made of metal, I get advantage. I don't know how much metal they're wearing because they're like.
The Necrodancer or somebody else?
The zombie I'm hitting.
Sorry, which one was that? I didn't
the one right
see
next to me.
They're not wearing a whole lot of metal.
Okay.
But 15 is luckily enough, so that's right. Fine.
So that much damage, and they can't take reactions until the start of their next turn.
Alright. They are significantly burnt, I think? Is that what you did to them?
Lightning. So
lightning.
Shock.
They're significantly shocked.
Yeah.
Yeah. Alright. Torin, all right, you're up.
Oh, I'm up. Right, that's what happened.
Can I move away as a bonus action, or no?
Sure, you can move. It's not a bonus action, it's your move action, but you can do it.
Oh, okay. I'll just, like, move over here.
Yeah.
Alright, so can I like, move over here and attempt to just call all the zombies to me? So they stop
sure.
everybody else?
Make a, let's say, intimidate check, just to be like, ah, and try to call everybody over.
These AoE taunts.
Yeah.
Alright, here goes. Perfect.
10 out of 10.
I'm gonna do a 4.
The most intimidating thing I've ever heard.
Yeah.
The soft crit fail.
It's really more of a whimper.
I just stand here and do nothing.
He's like,
Does that count as my turn, or can I, like, attempt to do something from here?
I'll let you attempt to do something else. That was kind of pathetic.
Try that projectile launcher thing, but facing the other way and try and attack the zombie that's next to Magnolia.
Okay. So the same device?
Yeah.
The TikTok displacifier or whatever?
Yeah.
Alright, go ahead.
Here we go again.
Alright. So, like a normal attack, right?
Yep.
Oh my god, this is the greatest night I've ever had.
Yeah, you rolls have been awful as well.
You just miss and teleport a chunk of rock out of this wall to about, like, here-ish.
Well, at least he didn't go over the tentacles.
Yeah, that would have been worse.
Maybe we should get rid of those.
Alright, Necrodancer's turn, and actually it's all the zombies' turn. So, Necrodancer is going to take some damage from being on fire. And I have to say, now his outfit's looking pretty hot.
Imagine.
Okay, then.
Ba-dum-tsh. Did you say anything about the dude you shocked? Did he have any movement inhibiting or anything?
It just says prevents reaction, so I don't know.
Okay, so no. He just couldn't take a reaction.
Yeah.
Alright, Magnolio, you're gonna have a big beefy dude and a dude with a cleaver trying to swipe at you. They both miss horribly. Like, they're just like, and you're still, like, flying around above them.
Classic zombie fashion.
Graceful.
Ursula, you're being attacked by a ham-fisted zombie. And I think that'll hit. You're gonna take, 12 damage. And then the last zombie is going to attack, Sartori, and miss terribly. Then the Necrodancer is going to try and make a little gout of purple flame attack Torin and Starchild.
No!
And are either of your ACs 14 or below?
No.
Alright, then you're fine.
Yes, deal with it, nerd.
Suck it, nerd.
Ursula, you're up. And while she's waiting back, I'm gonna run real quick. I'll be right back.
Okay.
Rest in pieces.
Guys, he's gone. Screw everything up.
Get him.
The DM's gone. Post memes.
Post memes.
There we go. Back. So I'm gonna attack this big guy. Oh, Nick's not here. Okay. Yeah. I thought I was holding things up. I grabbed my popcorn. We're good.
This is the first meme that I've found, and it's a bad meme that references an even worse meme.
It's good, though. I gotta get jokes. It's hard to take Kleptomaniac serious. chargers use puns to cut domaniacs because they always take things literally.
No, he's actually right here. Yeah.
Huh? I'm so looking forward to taking off this makeup.
Wait, you got like 9 more hours?
Yeah! 9 more hours.
I think you should charge more than $15 to wear that long.
My coworkers are cheap. For the kid.
For the kids.
Oh, he's back. Quick, everybody stop posting memes.
Everybody stop posting memes.
Alright. Sorry, it was Ursula's turn. What is up?
This guy.
I'm gonna attack this one.
Alright, go for it.
With my 2 remaining swords, I'll check real quick.
Yeah, you got 2 swords remaining right now, but you can scavenge before you attack if you prefer.
That's a great idea. Why don't I ever remember that? There we go.
Alright, cool. Back up to Max.
I'm 1 more than Max. What are you talking about?
You can't go above your max, remember?
He said I have some in my bag that I end up grabbing if that happens. I don't know.
No, your max is 8.
Oh, my max is 8?
Your max is 8. You start at 5. So that with your scavenge mechanic, you can keep going up, but then you have to max out at some point.
Got it, got it.
Careful balance.
Okay, either way, I'm going to throw 3 swords.
And you can scavenge twice in the turn if you decide to not attack.
I'm gonna attack, though. We know this.
Okay, yeah. Unused brilliance.
Okay, so you hit twice for 20 damage.
Cool.
Big Beefy there is somewhat injured, but not as injured as you would have hoped. Magnolio, you're up. Would you like to continue your rivalry with the Necrodancer in some form?
Yes.
Alright. Well, what have you got for us today?
Hmm.
Avenging Angel Magnolio.
Can I throw my shoe at him?
Sure, yeah, that seems like something you do.
Tie your shoe? Or
throw?
Throw.
Make 4 sets. Yeah.
Sure.
Well, I know that I find him distasteful.
Alright. Who throws a shoe?
This way more. Oh
yeah.
Man.
It's that insult injury.
Roll your, let's say 1d20 plus your dexterity modifier.
You should throw sand in his eyes.
Or do you think you're proficient in shoes? How much of a fashion guy do you think you really are? What do you think, guys? Is Magnolio proficient in shoes?
I
would say so.
Magnolio definitely wears
definitely.
Heels. Like,
all right, absolutely.
Heels.
Okay. All right. Yeah. All right. Let's go for it then. Let's give you the +5 instead of the +3 or whatever.
Magnolio is the fanciest plant rock star east of Necrocomicon.
Necrocomicon. Oh, that's wonderful. Alright, so could you... Oh, you made the attack already.
Okay.
Alright. That's a hit. Alright, cool. So, you do not a whole lot of damage. Let's go, okay, like, 1d4 plus 2. So let's roll 1d4 plus 2.
Oh, wait. Roll 1d4 plus 2?
Yep. But it's really the insult that hurts.
Yes.
He's gonna take that 3 damage, but he's gonna remember. He'll remember until he dies.
If he survives this encounter, this will haunt him for the rest of his days.
I mean, he's undead, so it's questionable whether you're actually gonna kill him, but like,
this
yeah.
Years of toll on his self-esteem.
That one person who stopped in the middle of a fight to chuck a shoe at him. Alright, Starcher, Al, you're up.
Okay. So you know how fights happen really friggin' fast?
Yeah.
Is this guy moving forward? Or stepping at all?
He might have been.
Can I force these zombies under him so he steps on them?
No, but you can try to trip him to make him fall on them.
I'll go with that option then.
Okay.
I'll move a little closer. No. Less mind distance.
Less delay.
Yeah.
Alright, so make a quick dexterity attack.
Okay. I guess it's not a dex save.
No. It's just using your dexterity as a stat.
Okay. That didn't work very well.
Not particularly. He kind of stumbles for a second, just kind of turns and gives you a what the fuck?
As a bonus action, I do the cha-cha slide.
Nice. Sartori, you're up.
All right. Let's move. Oh, I'm still on this. Move like. There. And then try to Eldritch Blast the Necrodancer.
Nice.
Once again.
Alright. That will be a hit this time.
Hooray.
I'm sure I have made his armor class somewhat inconsistent. But it's getting late.
a crit and a crit fail. Excellent.
Nice.
Painfully 16 average.
16 damage.
We only have 22 minutes to kill him? All right.
Yeah. He's running
he's
a little low.
He's still on fire, too.
He is still on fire. Torin, your turn. All time right. to break out the big guns if you got any.
Yeah, I hope so. Yeah, all right, so I'm going to do my basic, which ends up being two attacks. So you said roll... You was 4d20s?
Oh, if you had advantage. This time it's just 2.
Oh, okay, cool. 2d20s plus.
Just roll your 2d20s, we'll add those in afterwards, because... Yeah.
And...
Alright. So, this is probably going to be a miss. What's your mod?
5.
5? Okay, so the 19 is going to be a hit, the 12 is going to be a miss.
Alright, well, at least I got one in. Alright, damage?
Alright.
Oh boy. Yes. Great.
Wonderful.
Do I like stub his toe even? Also,
yeah, no, absolutely. You just kind of hit him. You kind of hit his leg instead of actually like any vital part of him, and he's like, "Ow!" What the heck, man? You hit me in the leg with a wrench.
That's the best I could do. All right, I tried to do it. At least I didn't throw a shoe at you or anything like that. That'd be ridiculous.
All right. Big Chubbs over here is going to go after Ursula. The other two are going to keep trying to swipe at Magnolio, except for this one who's going to kind of walk over to Starchild and take a swipe at him. Starchild, miss horribly. Ursula, miss horribly.
Yay!
Magnolio, miss horribly. Crit fail. Alright, so Big Chubbs is just going to take out this little zombie. He's just like swinging, and then you swoop out of the way, and he just nails him. Absolutely splatters him into the ground.
Wait, is he splattering the group of three?
No, it was this guy over here, squished, the one that was next to Magnolia,
oh,
but he's now gone.
I don't see anymore because he's dead.
Yeah.
Alright.
The Necrodancer is then going to use a Dark Flare Comet. Target this whole area over here, like the four of you and that one poor zombie caught in the crossfire.
Oh,
Is it like an actual comet coming?
Yeah, pretty much a purple comet just zips down through from the ceiling to come explode in that area. Make a dexterity save to get out of the way. Starchild, since you're at the center of it, you're at disadvantage.
All right. Can I gather a rope around my fist and attempt to punch it away?
Yes. I will allow you to make a basic attack in place of a dexterity saving throw.
Am I still at disadvantage?
Yeah. Actually, no, you're not. But it might not go well for you either way.
Is his my strength modifier? Never mind.
It's whatever your normal basic attack would be.
12.
All right, is that your attack or your saving throw?
That's my attack.
Okay, and what's your modifier on that? Like +3?
I think that my basic attack would be strength, right? Or do I use intelligence if I'm using a rope?
You probably use dexterity because it's considered a whip.
Then it would be 13.
Alright. So you don't really hit it that clean, but you do hit it. So your call on whether you just want to soak up all the damage and not have anyone else in the group take any, or if you just want to have the damage for the group.
I mean, in my opinion, you should soak up all the damage.
I think those are both the same thing.
I feel like you should soak up all the damage.
No, you can have it for everybody, or including yourself. Or you could just take it and negate it for the others. Okay.
I've literally taken no damage since I went to max HP.
Alright, Star Child. feel the burn.
Truly he is the Star Child, absorbing the power of the meteor.
30 damage.
Wait, what is the rule on using hit die? Like, do I have to wait
That's outside of combat, so it won't be relevant.
Right.
Can I, like, have flames come out of me at will because I just absorbed a meteor?
Probably. little flames, they're purple. You know, actually what'll happen is when you use your flaming rope powers, the flames are now purple instead of normal red.
Okay.
Alright, Ursula, you're up.
Okay.
For the record, I would probably recommend finishing the Necrodancer, because he doesn't have a whole lot of health left.
No, leave him to me.
I'm gonna juggle and throw my three swords.
Yo, you got a crit! Alright, so all three hit, and the last one's a crit.
Uh-huh. That's how we do
so
it.
What's the max damage on that? D10 plus 5, I think. So 15 plus 4, so that's 19, 27, 41. You do 41 damage to the Necrodancer.
What?
Yeah. So that's 139. Alright, yeah, he is clinging on by a thread. He is not looking so hot. Starchild is typing.
Oh, don't worry about it. I'm saving
him. Alright. Magnolio, you're up.
Alright, I would like to hit him with the flaming guitar again.
Alright, the flames or the guitar?
The guitar.
Alright. Just try and bash his skull in. Go for it.
Alright, so that is a... Mm-hmm.
Nice! Alright, yeah, that'll just get him. Alright, roll your damage to finish him off.
Alright, that'd be, D6, right?
Yeah.
Wait, is that this one
D6
or crap?
Oh, that'll do it. Okay, that is 8, which puts him just over his threshold, and he is down.
right.
Nice. So
no
the music cuts.
Only dreams now.
And just plays this stuff out of the speakers instead. Because he's dead now.
Yeah. Thank you for that clarification.
Is he getting dragged down?
Yeah, he just kind of like slowly fizzles and melts into the ground, and the little like beating heart that he was holding melts away too, and leaves behind the blade of the sword.
Before he disappears, can I ask him a question?
You could try.
What type of pace was he going to turn us into?
He does not reply.
Okay.
How many pieces of the sword do we have now?
I'm guessing
you've got
two
of the three. Pretty much you've got the hilt and you've got the blade, and now you just need the gem linchpin that'll keep them together.
I feel like that's something that we can just like, I mean, we got the guy who tinkers with things.
Absolutely, you could keep them together, but this is supposedly a magic sword. You probably need the actual correct piece for it.
I mean,
let's just roll until we crit.
Yeah, let's just, I would like ask to roll for that, but like there's no way that you would let us do that to just end the game.
Yeah, I'm not going to let you roll for it, mostly because if you did disrupt it at this point, it would just not. I don't feel like replanning that much. It is very late, and I'm not going to rewrite five chapters of the campaign.
Are these zombies still alive, or did they fizzle out?
They just kind of like dance their way out of the room.
Oh,
they're alive, but they don't. They've kind of lost their drive to kill you.
Are they alive though?
They're like alive.
Can I loot what's left of him?
Yeah, let's roll for loot.
Absolutely,
it's all about loot, man.
You guys can all do some investigation for loot.
Yes.
Can I use detect magic too to see if there's anything?
Sure.
It'll take a while though.
I want to take advantage. Can I?
You, I'm sure you had inspiration lying around.
Probably. I just punched a meteor.
All right. What are we saying? I want to know what the loot is.
All right, so let me just clean up the page a little bit. All right, so you all get some various loot of just, like, basic money items. You know, just, like, gold coins, gems, the basics.
Serious coinage?
Serious nice. Coinage. Like, whoa. Magnolio, you find a rapier of palette swapping. Which is essentially just a sword, which, upon will... can palette swap you. Just change whatever color it is that you wear to a different set of colors.
Good shit right there. I would need one of those in real life. That'd be awesome.
Oh, it'd be wonderful. Torin, find what appears to be like some sort of arc reactor.
Arc reactor.
Yeah.
Tony Stark was here?
I don't even know what that means.
I'm pretty sure he is Tony Stark. Just like this is the origin story.
Oh my god, we killed Tony Stark.
It's a reactor. Like it generates energy.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah, so you could use it to like power your tinkering devices and like help move you up as an artificer.
Sweet. I want to stick it onto the robot arm and attach it to my armor so that I now have a third appendage.
Nice.
Could you roll a quick, I don't know what check that would even be.
Where are you placing the appendage?
Wisdom?
Sure, wisdom will work.
I'm thinking like, I don't know, like offhand sort of here-ish. So
okay.
Does things, it might have a mind of its own because it has its own independent energy source, but like that's fine.
Okay. Yeah. So you've got your two normal arms and then a heavily armored, more effeminate arm.
I'm pretty sure that statement right there was the reason Age of Ultron became a movie.
I'm sure it's fine.
All right.
How well does it go if I have a total of 8 to put it together?
Okay, so you graft it on fine, but you're a little worried that it might try to strangle you in your sleep.
Right, I'm just going to take it apart and then maybe try again later.
Try again some other time. yeah, Steve, you're actually going to be done after this segment, I think.
Yes.
Right?
Okay. Yes, I am.
So I'll put that in the epilogue along with everything else, how you move on with your life to become Master Artificer with the Arc Reactor. And
oh, boy.
So you're going to stay behind with all this type of thing to work on your stuff, it seems like. I thought. All right, so Torin Artifices. Magnolio, what are you going to do with your life going forward? Since you have now defeated the Necrodancer and
Magnolio
become...
Magnolio is going to make a better nightclub than the Necrodancer.
Better nightclub? I could see that. Just revamp the place. It's got a good bass. It's got a great, the best
it's
speaker system in the room.
It's got a good location. It doesn't have the proper club.
Gotcha.
Got a good bass.
I like it. Okay.
For reference, this is what I was typing earlier. This is what my new flame ropes do. That link, 340.
340. You know you can link videos at times, right?
Yeah.
I don't know how to do that.
Oh, alright.
It's like when you're sharing the thing, you could share it at something, and then it changes something in the URL, and then you could just...
Oh.
It says, at, 3 something... minutes, seconds, etc.
Yeah, almost exactly like that, complete with the electro music.
Start at 3:40. For those of you who are lazy, new link.
Yeah.
There you go, look at that.
You could also put that in the Twitch chat if you want to share it with those people. Who's being fine? It'll be fine. Oh, cool. Fine. That's funny. All right. So yeah, that's so for Angela, this was your first time playing Dungeons and Dragons, right?
Second actually.
Oh, all right. What'd you think?
Fun.
All right. I'm glad you enjoyed yourself. Thanks for coming.
Thanks for having me.
All right. This was a good time. And, Steve, it's great to have you back at the party again.
Thank you.
I'm sorry the dice didn't exactly work out in your favor.
Yeah, no, those rolls, man. I'll probably be up for a little while, so, if you need another human to fill a spot, if somebody doesn't...
All right. Go ahead. I probably won't unless someone bails, but I'll let you know.
All right. Bye-bye.
Good night.
All right, have a nice night.
Good night, friends.
Good night.
All right.